Hello all, it is your friend Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing the deep fascia of the foot. And while we will do a quick overview of all the fascia of the foot, or the deep fascia, we will focus in on this important area referred to as the plantar aponeurosis. So as we know at this point in the year, there is deep fascia pretty much everywhere in the body. And that is certainly the case as well in the foot. And this, as we know, deep fascia is deep to the superficial or subcutaneous layer, but superficial to the muscles. And the deep fascia of the foot is continuous with the crural fascia, which is the deep fascia of the leg. The deep fascia on the dorsum of the foot, or on the superior surface of the foot, so if you're looking down at your foot, you are looking at the dorsal side of your foot. This deep fascia is relatively thin, but things become thicker when we're discussing the plantar surface, or the deep fascia of the sole of the foot. So that's what we're looking at, the sole of the foot or the plantar surface. And this fascia here is going to be referred to as plantar fascia. Now, if you think about it, it makes sense that the plantar fascia is going to be relatively thicker because this area undergoes a lot of stress, it bears a lot of weight. It is interacting with the environment when you walk or when wearing shoes or etc. So added protection is important. The medial and lateral parts of the plantar fascia are comparatively thinner than the central part, which is quite thick and forms this strong region right here, referred to as the plantar aponeurosis. This plantar aponeurosis is pretty hard to miss as it extends from the calcaneus. The calcaneus would be right in this region here, attaching to the medial tubercle of the calcaneus. And distally, it divides into these five bands, which you can see fairly clearly here, kind of throughout, that are forming these fibrous digital sheaths that will actually enclose the flexor tendons. The plantar aponeurosis plays a very important role in supporting and maintaining the medial longitudinal arch, which is the most prominent arch of the foot. We will discuss the arches of the foot in more detail in an upcoming learning objective, but it is important to note that the plantar aponeurosis's role here in terms of protection. It can really utilize the tensile strength of the aponeurosis, playing a role in preventing collapse upon vertical load, such as can occur during certain movements during locomotion. Now, as with so many structures in the body, the plantar fascia can become inflamed, particularly that plantar aponeurosis part, and this is referred to as plantar fasciitis. It typically presents as pain right around that attachment point on the calcaneus, the medial tubercle portion. Excellent. Thank you for your time and attention here, and please take time to review. And as always, please feel free to reach out if you have any questions.